Again, Wells is doing some tricky steps here. What I'm going to encourage you to do is this over here. The determinant of A times the determinant of B is the determinant of A times B. I would just do that, all right? He goes through a lot of stuff, though. If you go back over the notes for these prior two sections, it's really a lot of work, all right? A lot of work when this is something pretty simple. And let's say this is a recognizable pattern. Also easy to show and prove. Thank you.